at 9.
Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell says the Senate will likely vote to block President Trump's national emergency declaration. His comments come as his fellow Republican Senator Rand Paul says he will join Democrats and vote against Trump as well. Here to talk about this is Travis Kennedy, GOP Executive Director, and Manny Garcia, the Executive Director of the Texas Democratic Party. Gentlemen, thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Spencer, does Rand Paul represent a majority of Republicans or just Republicans in the Senate?
The president is certainly looking at the numbers on this one. It was a fundamental promise in the 2016 election, and it will be so for the 2020 election. I think that's evident just by how far the shutdown went. 77% of Republican voters and the majority of Republican lawmakers supported the declaration. It's just going to take a veto to get it passed because of the margins. And I think that last point is the most important when looking forward. Yes, he lost some Republican votes on this, but the thin margins are really overstating any perceived loss of support. In reality, he only lost 7% of Republican senators and 5% of Republican House members on this one. And the majority of those said they agreed with the ends but not the means.
Okay.
I don't think it's going to significantly impact his support in the ballot box or on Capitol Hill.
Manny, how do you see this playing out? You know, the president will probably veto it if the legislature isn't with him, then it would go to the courts. How is it going to go, you think?
Here's the first big question. You know, what did Ted Cruz and John Cornyn do when a billionaire is trying to take Texans' land? You know, that's not the kind of thing that folks look kindly to. And we really appreciate Congressman Castro's bipartisan work to make sure that, you know, the Constitution is protected, that our national security is protected, that it's not ransacked for a wall that, frankly, no one wants. And when you poll Texans in particular, no one wants the way Donald Trump is doing it right now. So they're really faced with that tough question. At the end of the day, Donald Trump's going to do what he's going to do. He's going to try to ransack national security to build this wall. And, you know, I think it is good to see when Texans come together and fight back. We shouldn't cower in front of this.
Spencer, Mitch said that he wished the president had not declared this state of emergency. Is this a strategic blunder for Trump, or you seem to think it's going to help him in the long run?
Well, he certainly still has the numbers behind him. We will see, certainly the next election, whether it was a strategic gain or just a non-starter. You know, there has been an emergency on the border for about 20 years now. It was an emergency back then, and because we didn't do enough against it, it just compounded on itself. And those Republicans that voted against it are nervous about executive power after President Obama did so much to expand it. There's an important distinction between executive orders that President Obama used and the emergency declaration being used here by President Trump. Emergency declarations have been used by every president because they are the foreign policy, the first one out there, and generally relate, these declarations relate to foreign policy. And it's important to remember that this emergency declaration is consistent with that. While he is addressing is really immigration from a foreign state, so it fits well within the precedent.
Manny, is there truly a national emergency on the southern border?
This is very, very, very simple. The government shouldn't be taking Texans' land away from them all across the Rio Grande border. That's why you see representatives up and down the border, duly elected officials, say no and vote for this resolution. That's why you're seeing Republicans and Democrats come together and vote against Donald Trump on this. You know, the issue at the border, while Republicans want to show that this is somehow a war zone or, you know, things are falling apart, you know, the border is a vibrant community. It is a growing community, and we need to make sure that when Texas's strong relationship with Mexico, our strongest trading partner, when that is jeopardized, that Republicans and Democrats come together and make sure that that's not going to happen. So John Cornyn and Ted Cruz really have to answer up and face their fellow Texans today.
Okay. They will. Manny, Spencer, thank you both very much.